Hello students and welcome to DAV Mohil Public School Sita Savangi. Let's begin an online session of standard 9th mathematics, and the topic is number system. In that we are going to discuss about the laws of exponents for real numbers. In the earlier session you have learnt about the different operations on real numbers, and today we have a brief review about laws of exponents for the real. If a positive real number and n is a positive integer, then the reciprocal, the principal nth root of a is unique positive real number x such that x raised to the power n equals to a. The principal nth root of a is denoted by a raised to the power 1 upon n or nth root of a. You have seen in standard 8 square root and cube root. So here 2 and 3 instead of that nth root of a, and you can write in the power it is as a raised to the power 1 upon n. Now if a and b are the positive real numbers and m and n are the rational numbers, then we have the laws of exponent which we have studied in the last year also, that is standard 8th and standard 7th also, we have studied the laws of exponents. So here the base is a and the power are m. So a raised to m into a raised to n equals to a raised to m plus n, means powers are added if the bases are equal and there is a multiplication sign. The second rule says when the bases are equal and powers are different, then there is a difference between the powers, and the base we have to take as a common, means a raised to m divided by a raised to n equals to a raised to m minus n. Now third law says power of power gives you the multiplication of the power, means a raised to m and that whole raised to n if there, then we have to multiply the powers, that is m and n. So it is a raised to m n. Fourth power says if the power is negative, we have to change the place. If it is in the numerator, we have to take that whole number as a, in the denominator, and if it is in the denominator, we have to take it to the numerator. So here fourth law says a raised to minus n equals to 1 upon a raised to n. Fifth is if the combined two numbers are there, a into b, and whole power is n, then individually we can give the powers, that is a raised to n into b raised to n. The same laws we have studied, dear students, last year. A upon m raised to the power n equals to a raised to n upon b raised to n. Now if the power has the rational number, that is a m upon n, then m is the power, and means numerator is the power and the denominator is the root, means nth root of a raised to the power m, and we can write it as nth root of whole raised to the power m or mth power of a and its nth root, or a to the power m upon n, where m and n are the natural numbers. Let's see some examples. So here first we will simplify 64 raised to the power 1 by 3. So 64 is nothing but the 4 cube. So 4 cube whole raised to the power 1 by 3. And as power of power multiply, we will multiply both the powers, that is 3 into 1 by 3. So 3 gets cancelled. 4 raised to the power 1 means it is 4. Now the second example is 125 whole raised to the power minus 1 by 3. Now here the power is negative and the number is in the numerator. So we will write by removing the negative sign as a positive power. So it comes in the denominator. So it is 1 upon 125 raised to the power 1 upon 3. Now 125 is nothing but the 5 into 5 into 5, that is 5 raised to the power 3. By prime factorization you can find out this. So here again power of power, so power of power multiply, so 3 multiply by 1 by 3 means 3 gets cancelled, and the answer is 1 upon 5. Now in the second simplifier here, 27 raised to the power minus 2 by 3. So again there is a negative power. So we will take that number to the denominator to make the power as positive. Now 27 is nothing but the 3 cube, means 3 into 3 into 3. So we will write down 27 as 3 cube, and already 2 upon 3 is the power. Then we will multiply this. 3, 3 gets cancelled. 2 as it is, so 1 upon 3 raised to the power square, and 3 into 3 means 9. The answer is 1 by 9. Now the fourth is the rational number, and rational number has the negative power. So we will take the both numbers as it, we will change actually. Numerator goes to the denominator and denominator goes to the numerator, and power becomes positive. See the third step. 25 upon 64, this whole raised to the power 3 by 2. As the places change, negative sign is removed. Now 25 means 5 square and 64 means 8 square. So we will take out that square common. 3 by 2 into 2 means power of power we have to multiply. So 2 and 1 by 2 gets cancelled. So the power 3 is left, and 5 cube equals to 125. And 8 cube equals to 512. So like this we will have to simplify the numbers. See here. Now here we have to remove the radical sign, that is square root sign. So let's see how to solve this type of problems. Now we are root 4 whole raised to the power minus 3. Now root means square root means 1 by 2 is the power. So remove that radical sign, that is square root sign, and put the power as 1 by 2. Now power 1 by 2 and already minus 3 is there. So the total power becomes 4 raised to the power minus 3 by 2. And remaining, you know how to solve this. As you removed now the radical sign, negative denominator, negative power is there. So the number goes to the denominator. So it is 1 upon 4 raised to the power 3 by 2. Now 4 cube means 64. So 1 by 2 means 8 square. 1 by 2 square square gets cancelled. So it comes only 8. So it is 1 upon 8. Now see the second example. Here root 5 raised to the power minus 3 and root 2 raised to the power minus 3. So if you will remove the radical sign, we can write it as 5 raised to the power 1 by 2 into minus 3 and 2 raised to the power 1 by 2 into minus 3. So the numbers becomes power and power multiply. So the number becomes 5 raised to the power minus 3 by 2 into 2 raised to the power minus 3 by 2 equals to. Now the powers are equal, so we will write down if the combined basis as 5 multiply by 2 and that whole raised to the power minus 3 by 2. So 5 into 2 means 10, so it becomes 10 raised to the power minus 3 by 2. As negative power, it comes in the denominator. Now 10 cube means 1000, and 1000 is nothing but the 10 raised to the power 3. So when you solve it, you have to put 1 zero above and below so that you can write it in the form of the square. So it is 10 raised to the power 1 by 2, and here 100 square, because on 1 you are getting 4 zeros. So it is 100 square into 1 by 2, 2 2 gets cancelled. So it is, the final answer is 10 1 by 2 upon 100. Now the third question is, here in the denominator you will see the radical sign, but it is the cube root. So when you remove it, you have to give the power as 1 by 3, not 1 by 2, because it is cube root sign. Then power up of power multiplied. So 4 raised to the power minus 5 into 1 by 3. So it becomes 1 upon 4 raised to the power minus 5 by 3 is equal to. Now see here, in the denominator you are having the negative sign, so that number comes in the numerator. So it is 4 raised to the power 5 by 3. Now 5 by 3 means actually 3 plus 2 upon 3. So 3 by 3 plus 2 by 3. So 3 by 3 means 1. So 4 raised to 1 multiplied by 4 raised to 3 is the final answer. Now, dear student, this is a small assignment for you. So, today we have learnt about the laws of exponents of the real numbers. Try to solve it. Thank you. Have a nice day.